Hello and welcome to a new video on cryptography for everybody. This is the first video in 2022. And in my last video of 2021, I published a musical cipher challenge. And I invited you, the viewers of this channel, to solve this challenge. And in fact, only after 48 hours, I got the solution of the challenge. So this was really fast. And on top of that, there was a nice discussion in the codes group of Reddit, who also was about my challenge. So there were some people on Reddit trying to solve the challenge. And sadly, they were 2 hours too slow, because the one who solved the challenge sent it, or the solution, 2 hours before it was solved on Reddit to me. And people were able to win a Helen Fushy Gaines book, the Helen Fushy Gaines book, Cryptanalysis, and I already send it to the solver. But if you are interested in solving the challenge on your own, then you should stop this video and watch the previous video of last year, because there you can see the challenge without the solution. In this video, I want to show you the solution. We will also have a look at the Reddit post, and I want to give you a brief update of my symbol cipher component in Cryptool 2. But first, let's have a look at the challenge on Reddit. I'm here now in the Reddit group codes, and as you can see here, they dedicated a nice post to my challenge. They also referenced my video here, and here you can see a part of the challenge. It is a paper which consists of notes. You have here these musical notes, and these musical notes encrypt a message. And as I said, the first one who was able to send me the original message won a crypto book from Helen Fushy Gaines. And yeah, here you can see the people did on Reddit was to create this nice transcription here. And in fact, it is the first thing you should do when you want to solve a challenge. Of course, when you only have a piece of paper, a photo or so, you need a transcription. The transcription is just a mapping from the original paper to, for instance, here, ASCII symbols. In our case, here the user with a number created this transcription, and he mapped each of my notes to a letter. And then here you can also already see the solution. I really love the fact that they hide the solution so that people can try the challenges on their own, and then they can reveal the solution and they can then see if their solution is correct. And here you also see some discussion, but I don't want to go into detail of the discussion here. I want to copy the transcription of that user here, and then we will analyze the ciphertext on our own. To do so, we go back to Cryptool 2. I'm here now back in Cryptool 2, and I have the transcription of my challenge in the clipboard. And to analyze an unknown ciphertext, we have to first find out what kind of cipher this may be. I already created videos about this, so have a look at my previous videos about solving unknown ciphertexts. To determine which kind of cipher we have here, I search for frequency. That is what I want to have. Frequency analysis. And we have this Friedman test for classical ciphers. That's actually what I was searching for. We open the Friedman test because the Friedman test can tell us if it's a monoalphabetic or polyalphabetic substitution cipher. Remember, we have originally notes, and the notes are, you could say, more or less a monoalphabetic substitution cipher. The original cipher scheme tells us that we have a letter mapped to a note. But in my challenge, I told the people that there is more involved in this cipher. It's not just a simple monoalphabetic substitution cipher. I remove the components I don't need here. We will make this a little bigger. And I think I remove the empty lines here. And now let's have a look at the distribution. And here you can see the letter frequency of the ciphertext, of the transcription. And as you can see, it's not really monoalphabetical. For instance, then if it's just plain monoalphabetic substitution cipher, the N would be of very high frequency, the E would be of very high frequency. And for instance, the W and the X would not have such high frequencies. And the Friedman test component also tells us, by comparing the provided text or the index of coincidence of the provided text with a given index of coincidence, that it thinks this could be polyalphabetic. And since I created the cipher with Cryptool 2, people could assume that I used the Wiginaire cipher. So we go here into the Wiginaire analysis. Then we put in our cipher text. We use the Wiginaire analyzer. Classic Wiginaire, key length 1 to 20 is fine. And let's test it. And then we will see that it actually doesn't work. And in the Reddit group, I also saw that people were discussing that this is polyalphabetic, but they had problems to solve it. And people who know me and already solved challenges that I created know that I tend to do a very mean thing, and that is what I also did here in that challenge. I reversed the ciphertext. So we can use the string operator here. Connect the string operation component and then say we want to reverse our text here. So that means we read our ciphertext from the end to the beginning in the reversed order. Now let's press play. And I will increase the size of the Wiginaire analyzer. And here you have it. We have a It's actually a Wiginaire cipher with a key length of 12. The key word is Happy New Year. And then the key, the text itself, we can have a look here. I increase the size. No more champagne, and the fireworks are me and you. I think here are some transcription errors. So this is here and this should be we are, and me and you feeling lost and feeling blue exits the end of the there are a lot of errors, so this transcription is not perfect. But to be honest, it's really difficult to transcribe using notes. You have to be very precise. And this transcription here, we see there are a few errors. Here we have Happy New Year, Happy New Year, Happy New Year, Happy New Year. And yeah, then this ciphertext here, or the plain text used for creating the ciphertext, is actually part of an ABBA song that I found that is related to New Year, since I created that on the last day of the last year. And the one who sent me the solution sent me a perfect deciphered text. And yeah, as I said, I created that text by first encrypting using the Wiginaire cipher, then I reversed the ciphertext, and then I used the symbol cipher component that I'm currently working on. And that is something I also want to show you in this video. So we go back to the start center. You probably, when you have seen my last video, also tried the component symbol cipher component. But if you did not, you can try it now. And I uploaded an update to the Cryptool store. So you go to the Cryptool store, then you see here symbol cipher, and here this is now a yellow exclamation mark. That means for me I have installed an old version, so I will do an update. Yes. And then you have to restart Cryptool 2, and that is what I want to do now. Restart. And I want to really exit, yes, and I don't want to save, and I don't want to save. then Crypto2 restarts. And now we can use the new version of the symbol cipher component. To do so, I create a new workspace. I need the symbol cipher component. I need text input. And I need a picture output, since the symbol cipher component creates images. Then I connect both components here, or the three components. And I say, hello world, this is a test. And now I can show you what I have done in that component. First of all, I started working on PigPen cipher, but this doesn't work now, but it's already in the settings. But when you change to musical ciphers, the musical ciphers already work. And then we have two schemes. We have the Daniel Schwenter scheme. That is the scheme that I actually used in my challenge. And to make it more nice, we use some vertical bars. For instance, we could use vertical bars to separate the words. Now we have separators between our words. This is now encrypted using Daniel Schwenter's scheme. And I also included a scheme from another cryptograph from that time, also from the 16th century, I think, or 17th century, I'm not sure, 100%, 60 or 17th. But when we now press play, you can see that our notes have different appearance. And Wilkins used this style of notes, and of course he has a different assignment from texts to notes. Yeah, and this is everything that I wanted to do in this short video. You now know how to solve the cipher, so reverse the ciphertext. And I have shown you the two new, or the one new cipher scheme in my symbol cipher component, and probably in the next weeks I will add more of more different symbol ciphers to this component. I think the next one will be the Freemason cipher, the PigPen cipher. Yeah, and as I said, this is everything I wanted to show you in this video. I hope you liked it. If yes, please give a thumbs up. This really helps me to grow the channel and make the channel and Crypto2 more popular. And if you did not yet subscribe to this channel, this also would really help me to grow the channel and make Crypto2 more popular. So thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.